So, oh, I love your energy. You guys are the best.
Yes, because they are free people.
Oh.
They have their minds and their hearts free.
I wonder what that means. Mm-hmm. Perfect timing.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, what is this?
What? Is this kale?
Oh.
Is that the tea?
I told you they're free people and this is
seaweed.
The smell of
the ocean.
The ocean.
Oh my goodness.
So today's topic must have something to do with the sea.
It must.
Yes. We're going to show everybody the chill life of Taiwanese islands.
Let's check out check the VCR. Out.
Green Island is a small volcanic island in the Pacific Ocean about 33 kilometers off the eastern coast of Taiwan. It is the fourth largest island in the Taiwan area. Green Island has many bizarre volcanic rocks that have been cooled to create a rich and natural landscape. The Asahi Hot Spring on the island is a rare and considered one of the most famous underwater hot springs in the world. The prison on the island used to hold important gang leaders, so it is sometimes called the hometown of the kingpins. The Human Rights Park on Green Island memorializes the wounds of Taiwan history. This island is only about 16 square kilometers, but it is rich in marine resources, natural ecology, cultural stories, and precious undersea hot spring geology. Off of the southwestern coast of Taiwan's main island, another outer island, Xiaoliuqiu, covers an area of only 6.8 square kilometers. Geographically, due to the influence of the Kuroshio current tributaries, the seawater temperature remains above 25 degrees Celsius all year round, making it very suitable for snorkeling even in winter. When it comes to water activities, the density of sea turtles in the waters is the highest in Taiwan. The traditional festival on the island, the Wang Ye worshipping ceremony, is held every 3 years, which is a very unique folk activity in Taiwan. Let's hear from our friends who like to island hop and see what interesting island experiences they have.
Lovely islands of Taiwan. We have two delicacies.
Okay.
This
is seaweed.
Is seaweed. And this is a seaweed shaved ice.
That is so peculiar. I never expected seaweed to be something sweet. I always thought it was just savory.
I know, maybe like soup or something.
That's really sweet seaweed.
It's really seaweed.
Really sweet seaweed.
And this represents Green Island. Who is really familiar with Green Island here? Pedro?
All of us, maybe.
Yeah.
I am, of course. Yeah. Green Island is also very familiar with me, because I'm a star.
So. Oh, yes.
Okay.
But I like
confident.
It a lot. Yeah. Taiwanese Tom Cruise.
Mm. Yes. Oh, yeah.
But yeah, I go often. I went like 4 times.
A little bit. Yes, I got it.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, it's my top one, probably.
Okay.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
You go there quite a lot.
Yeah. 4 times, 5 times already.
Wow.
But I think I never had that one. Like seaweed.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah. Let's try it.
Try it.
I'm a bit disabled now. I go for the seaweed.
Yes.
Because the hongdou, like the beans, I had them
go
before.
Go for the seaweed.
Yeah. Come on.
Cosima's face is like...
Whoa. It's seaweed.
It's very seaweed.
It's very seaweed.
Have you tried it?
Smells like the sea.
Yeah,
it's good.
Okay.
Actually, tastes like nothing.
How is it? Mm.
You like it?
Like putting some sugar in the sea and having a...
Yeah.
Do you like it?
It's good, it's good.
It's good, huh? We can have the whole
thing.
Very
nice thing. Okay, it helps.
And then we have Xiaoliuqiu. This is, we call it Mahuazhen. Mm-hmm. What's it in English?
The English name gets people a little bit confused because it's called hemp flower.
Okay.
Yeah.
And in the US, hemp flower means cannabis.
Right.
Marijuana.
Right.
Right, and so people look at that and they're like,
Huh. Oh, man.
Well, see their face.
This is really tasty.
This is really good.
It may as well have cannabis in it. This is so good.
麻花 also means braids.
Right. So it's like hemp rope, right?
It's a fishing village or a fishing area. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So the fishermen call it after the rope that they used to tie the boats to the border pier. Yeah.
This is so nice. Mm. This is like a crunchy donut.
Right. That's the...
So that's why they're invented, because the fishermen, when they take their breakfast out to sea, then the bread gets all soggy. And so they would just take the dough,
deep fry it,
so it isn't soggy.
Oh, that's how it comes from.
Yeah.
That's clever.
So, Ray, you live in Xiaoyuqiu, right?
I sure do.
And you work as a freediving instructor.
Yes.
So what brought you to the island?
Originally for a job in 1998 in the finance industry.
Right.
And I spent 20 years between Hong Kong and Taipei.
Okay.
Right. And then I got laid off.
Oh.
And I thought, okay, I'll just go learn some freediving, become a freedive instructor, and then come back, work in the, find another job in finance.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then the pandemic came, getting a job back in finance was more difficult, and I thought, hey, we'll see how this freedive thing goes.
Mm. It worked out. I mean, you're still at it, you're still enjoying it.
Well, the money's not as much, but I'm a lot happier.
Jenny, you're staying in Xiaoyuqiu as well, right?
Not really, I stay in Taipei, but I visit for the Luyudao every summer.
Okay.
And I also visit Xiaoyuqiu every year, so that's why I'm here to share with and Taiwanese perspective about this two islands.
Right. Mm. Yeah. So let me ask you, the two islands, which is your favorite?
That's a hard question.
Question of the day.
Actually, I like Green Island better, but today
Ray, do something about it.
Xiaoyuqiu.
It's a lot easier to visit Xiaoyuqiu.
Right?
Yeah, it is.
It's a 20-minute ferry ride, right?
Yeah.
From Taipei, you take the high-speed railway, one and a half hour to Kaohsiung, Zuoying, right? And then
you have to go to Donggang,
and then the 20-minute ferry.
That's really fast.
This is Taiwan, the small island and the convenience.
Mm-hmm. Wait.
But Green Island is not that convenient.
No. You need to take a boat or fly over.
No, but Green Island, you can take a flight from Taipei to go to Taito 1 hour, and after you take 20 minutes only, go to the Green Island.
That flight has like 12 seats.
So hard.
And you take a boat, it's only 40 minutes.
Lena, how do you go to Green Island? Which do you choose, water or... The flying.
Yeah, flying.
I think for the flight, it's pretty hard to find. I don't know, maybe you can give me the contacts so I can book for you. I never got a chance to take an airplane to there. And I've heard it's very small airplane, so when you take it, it's kind of bumpy. So if you're scared of flying, better not take it, take a boat.
Wow. It's safe.
Have faith.
If you're taking a ferry, you gotta keep in mind that a lot of people have seasick.
Right.
So sometimes what happens, you do?
I have massive seasick, motion sickness that kills me, and I'm a diver.
Aren't you Taiwanese? Like, you live on the island.
I know, that's ironic.
I have to make that clear. Like, even though we are like on an island, if you live in Taipei, there is not really that island kind of reality that really comes to your life every day.
You can always take a ferry on Danshui River, you know, just to
practice.
Sure.
And that's just the MRT, right? Take the red line all the way to the end. Yeah.
Exactly. So when's your first trip to Green Island?
It was a thing 3 years ago around that. And it was very interesting, very memorable because of the seasick. So taking the ferry, I and my friend, we had breakfast together. We ate the same thing. And then we got on the ferry and he was like, oh, actually, you know, I gotta tell you that I feel really bad when there are waves. I was like, it should be fine. Like, come on, the waves are not that big. Suddenly, out of nowhere, the wave came.
Oh.
So it was like super bumpy. We were like literally jumping like this. And then I look in front, someone was like with the bag there, puking.
It's a chain reaction.
And the ironic thing is, I was the only one not puking there. I was just like, oh my God, where should I go? And the whole boat smelled so terrible.
Oh,
it was like, but once you arrive to the island, you feel like, wow, you know, you forget everything happened on the boat. It's just like so beautiful, so pretty.
You're making the trip sound like a cleanse. Like you clean out the insides and you're like, oh.
You start new. Kasima, do you remember your first trip?
Actually, it was pretty chill. We took the train to Taidong. I usually also don't have seasickness.
Okay.
So I was like, it's fine, I don't need medicine. And all of my friends were like, Do you have the medicine? Did you prepare medicine? We need to remember to take it now, okay? They've been to Green Island the year before, so they were like, we know, take it. Even though you don't have seasickness, take
it. Listen to that.
Yeah. Yes. So I was like, okay, 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 I will take it. And yeah, I started to feel sick on the boat.
Oh, no. Really? Okay.
But I didn't throw up. It was just like a feeling in the gut.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But otherwise, I was fine.
Okay. Well, that's pretty good. That's pretty good.
When you go to Green Island, there is a must go. You enjoy the sea, but also the hot springs.
There's a hot spring.
Have you went? Pedro, you've been?
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, like, it's called 早日温泉.
早日温泉. You have to go for the sunrise. It's the best moment to go.
Yes.
Like, well, like the name entails.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
There you go. That's the one. You have to wake up at 4 in the morning when it's still dark.
Yes.
Go there, and it's full of normally of old people.
Right.
And they are, very nice, like telling me, oh, 好帅, 汤姆克鲁斯. They gave me a lot of.
He's just gonna keep going.
It's what happens.
Yeah, like in the dreams, right?
It's the reality.
It's true. It's true. Sorry.
It's how it went. And then they gave me a lot of wenchuan dan that you can boil there. Like,
there's
a tank where you can boil the eggs.
So this is the breakfast.
Yeah, for free.
And it gets that like perfect runny consistency, right, in the yolk, so it's not too dry.
The inside, the yolk is still like. Oh. Liquid and
hot spring egg.
Good one.
And so actually, here is one and only 3 salt waters, hot spring, and the wort.
So the water is actually salty. It's seawater.
It's salty, seawater, actually. I think that there's only 3 in the world of the places. Mm-hmm. So one is in Ludao, and one is in Japan, and one is in Italy. Because, so that is really unique.
And Ludao is a volcanic island.
Right.
So that's why they have this.
That
and
sense,
in Mandarin, it used to be called Huo Sao Dao.
Right, fire
which
burning
means,
the island.
Yes.
But so now it's just Green Island.
Ooh la la, who's this? Is it Jenny?
It's my dream. Enjoy the sunrise, actually. And because for the Zhaozhi hot spring, before they have another name as Asahi hot spring.
Asahi. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Asahi in Japanese is means sunrise.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
so the best time to visit here at sunrise. Yeah.
Okay. Super beautiful.
Especially it looks so nice once you arrive. It's so dark, you cannot see anything. You're like, really, there's a hot spring? And then once the sun comes out, you're sitting in the water, you're like, oh my god, this is the best morning.
I also want to introduce another attraction that is called National Human Rights Museum and Green Islands. Because actually before they have a history about, here they have the present, about the life they're living in here. Mm. So I recommend that if you visit there, so you can book for their tour guides and that is for free. I booked for like 4 or 5 times. So yeah, I follow for the tour guides. So the 4 or 5 times and each for like 40 minutes to 2 hours.
Okay.
So it depends how many times that you have.
Okay.
And one day, I met a female tour guide there, and she talked about one of the story with the politic prisoners and with the girls, locals.
Right. Mm-hmm.
They have the romantic story. And
didn't they make that into a movie?
Yeah, and after to the end...
I think they were just filming that.
Okay.
And after to the end, the female tour guide told me that girl is her grandma.
Oh!
So,
it's like Titanic.
Yes.
Really?
Kind of like, that has really touched me because sometimes we will feel that story is only on the textbook.
Right. Yes.
So that is history, but for her, that is real life.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I really like that kind of story. And actually, in Green Island right now, they still have another jail. It's not in the same place with the museum. They have another jail. They currently use it.
They make it cute, but it's still a jail.
Yeah, but you can take a lot of photos outside.
Okay.
Yeah, they won't stop you.
There's no prison on Shallow Chill.
That sounds great. Hey, point Shallow Chill.
You've lived in Taipei before, right?
Yeah.
So what's the life difference between on Shallow Chill, on the main island?
As soon as I want to come to Taipei, I want to leave.
Really?
Okay, thank you.
So,
thank
you for coming, Ray. I really appreciate you, man. Thank you.
So you missed the island. You missed the chillness, right?
Absolutely, yeah. No, I had a lot of health problems. Like, before I moved to Shaolucho, I had something called fibromyalgia, and it's just like a lot of chronic pain, chronic fatigue. And all of it went away after living in Shaolucho.
Really?
Yeah. Is it because of pressure?
You know, living in a big city, we become disconnected with nature. You know, inside, artificial air, artificial light, no connectedness to the earth, to nature. And so once I was able to wake up in the morning and see the morning sun, walk on the beach, breathing clean air.
Yeah. Hey, don't you feel like the small islands out of the main islands, they have 28 hours a day or something? Time is much
time
more
slower.
Yeah, a friend of mine said that people on Xiaoluqiu have time to be kind.
Xiaoluqiu is really special because they do care about the environment a lot.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
The island is very small, so whatever trash ends up there, it's very hard to deal with it. So what people try to do is to prevent you creating that trash.
Right.
So what they have is very interesting. They don't use money there. I mean, I'm kidding, they do. They have this. So it's called the Google coin?
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Right. Google bean. Yeah. Okay. It's made of plastic.
Really?
You can take it.
Sometimes they pick maybe like shore, they clean the shores.
Yeah, yeah.
It's got a number, a serial number on it.
Actually, an artist, what he does, he cooperates with some people who do beach cleanup.
Yes.
So they pick up the trash and then from that trash they make those coins.
Yes.
And each coin is unique, that's why there's a number there.
Okay.
So if you can look at the design of each coin is always different. It's
okay.
All handmade work. And how can you get that? You can either buy it or you can go help with the beach cleanup, right?
Oh.
Right?
So you can exchange it
for,
with recycling
so
that you pick
if
up?
If you join them, you help them throughout the whole day, they give you this. And then you can exchange this coin for some gifts at Xiaoluqiu. For example, this bowl, which you can use when you go to night market.
Yes.
Yeah. Or you can, if you don't have the coin, you can also rent it there.
Yeah.
So you just pay the deposit. You get the bowl. After you finish, you go bring the bowl back and they will give you all the money. So technically you can rent it for free.
Okay, so it's to reduce single use.
Yeah, so you go to the night market, no package, nothing. Isn't it amazing?
Yay!
Really, yeah. That is a really good system.
That's really neat. Because the people that love the sea really wanted to protect it.
Right.
Who's seen sea turtles in Xiaoluqiu?
Yes. Everyone.
100%. Yes, that was a question for you.
Yeah, I've been there, I've been there.
It's the only one where you can do the three things I love the most.
Yes.
Cliff jumping, rock climbing, plus nudism.
The three things. Nudism.
We have pictures now.
Okay.
Let's see.
I love how they created the sea turtle
on
it. Because sea turtle is such a representative animal for Xiaoluqiu, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the best way to get close to it, to observe it, is to...
Redive?
Get in the water. Free dive, or scuba diving, or whatever.
Just free dive. Not snorkeling, not scuba, just free dive.
Hold your breath.
Yeah, what gear to prepare? How do I... You know, if I want to go see sea turtles.
Get something like...
Oh, wow, you prepared.
This.
Ooh.
Oh.
Hey.
But I don't, this is more for snorkeling.
Right, yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Not
you
quite
just,
for free
you just
diving.
Just said no snorkeling.
We call this Teletubbies.
Oh, Teletubbies?
That's a good name.
Yeah.
It's for children.
Is that you?
For kids.
Oh.
Yeah,
that's me.
That's him.
Yeah.
You're kind of wearing a different thing there.
I think this is good for people who are afraid of the water.
Yes.
If it gives them a sense of
claustrophobia.
Of safety.
Mm-hmm.
But you can't free dive in this because the pressure will
crush
squeeze
your face.
On your face. Yeah.
Mm. But that is for tourists or
snorkeling.
If you're not familiar with the sea, you can actually put this on because it'll keep your face dry.
Yeah.
You can wear the makeup, right?
Yeah.
Go snorkeling.
But don't, because the makeup might pollute the sea.
Yeah.
So no makeup, just enjoy the sea, enjoy the sun, get tanned.
Mm.
This is what you're on the island for,
huh? Yeah. Cool.
And in order to get this awesome photo shoot, you need to...
Take a free dive course for me.
and second, go find some scuba divers.
Yes.
Create the bubbles for you.
It's the thing I love most about scuba divers is they give me the bubbles to take nice photos.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Talking about sea turtles, representative animal for Xiaoluqiu.
Absolutely.
I heard, you know, 100% you'll see them. If you go on the island.
99%?
99.9?
Yeah.
Who's seen sea turtles in Xiaoluqiu?
Yes.
Everyone. 100%.
Yes, that was a question for you.
Yeah, I've been there.
Actually, I have a funny story. When I went to Xiaoluqiu for the first time, my friend told me that there are a lot of sea turtles. So I was like, Oh, come on, it should be very hard to see sea turtles, especially in Taiwan. Like, the island looks so developed. So I was like, no way you can see that. So I put the goggles on, I entered the water, and I was like, I run out screaming. I was like, I saw a sea turtle. I was so scared because it was so huge.
Yeah,
I only seen it on the pictures. Yes. I was like, I was really, really scared because it was like, kind of very near me. And I didn't know what to do, so I was like, oh my god. And then I went in water again, I had like goosebumps and everything. I was like, oh my god, I'm like seeing sea turtles right in front of me. It was so beautiful, like swimming there gorgeously. Oh my god.
And they're really chill. They just lie there, right?
They're just like eating the whole time. They don't mind you.
They're just like, all right.
Yeah.
Go away.
Go away, excuse me. I'm eating.
But you cannot touch them.
Yeah.
If you touch them, you get shouted at by the coach.
Yeah.
Normally the coaches are there.
Sense one. 300,000 fine. Yes, if you touch them. So please keep your hands to yourself.
Yeah.
And take photos, leave bubbles, or don't leave bubbles. Free divers.
Bubbles are allowed.
When I went scuba diving in Xiaolochou for the first time, I was like so busy just trying to figure out how will I survive underwater because it was my first time and I was kind of scared with all the equipment.
Wow.
And then like the coach was like tapping on my shoulder and he's like, oh look, there's a sea turtle. And I was like, wow, that's awesome. I was like,
did
really
you scream
amazed,
underwater?
Of course not. Like, how can I scream?
yes. Yeah. Wow.
So oh wow.
My friend, she was like, she didn't pay attention to our coach, she just paid attention to all the sea turtles.
I remember the highest record of turtles that were counted in one dive was around like 15 or 18.
Yeah. Oh, wow. 15 or 18?
Yes, we were pretty lucky. Wow. We were shooting.
Ooh. What's that?
Where is that?
We have... Oh, these are this is Xiaolochou.
Oh, actually in last year, I think it's 2021, they have a research and they observed that have like more than 800 sea turtles around of the Xiaolochou on this island.
Wow. So I think that's island.
Yeah, so I think that is the numbers of it.
Okay,
so
the numbers of the turtles.
So the turtles kind of like hang out in one area, is that what that means? Okay, wow.
So it's pretty cool.
That's a check-in place for all the tourists.
Yeah, in Xiaolochou, when you walk on the beach and you see people standing there grouping somehow, it means there's a sea turtle. Yeah, they're like all taking pictures, videos.
So they're like local celebrities.
Yeah. They are local.
Five rules when you see a sea turtle.
Yes.
Don't feed them.
Mm-hmm.
Don't touch them.
Yep.
Give them 5 meters distance. Don't swim above them.
Okay.
In case they want to come for air. And wear
reef safe
sunscreen.
Okay.
Or none at all.
Okay.
I prefer none at all.
Yeah.
You can just wear the clothes, the covers.
Yeah, right.
The wetsuit.
Wear your wetsuits.
Right.
Oh, so this is a sea.
I love the reef there.
Perfect visibility.
Yes.
Yeah. It's so crazy.
It's incredible, like how far you can see in that
Sometimes
water.
Sometimes up to 30 meters.
Hey, you can spot the sea turtles. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
There are a lot.
10.
And this is like a Where's Waldo kind of
thing. Yeah, it is. Do you know there are a couple of underwater stars, which are sea turtles? Yes.
What are they called?
They're called...
Oh, this is a hall of
fame.
Yes. Xiao Po Dong is because the shell, I think, was hit by
a boat or something.
Yeah. And it had
so he's got a little tear?
Yes.
A big chunk taken out.
Xiao Po Dong.
But he still loves people, so he comes out the most.
I recognize her. It's Jenny Turtle.
This was Jenny?
I think this is Jenny.
Jenny.
My twins.
Oh.
Named
I recognize
you.
Her. And actually, I met her about like 3 times in Xiaolochou.
Really?
In Jenny Turtle.
Wow.
Yeah.
Do you have exchange Instagram accounts? What's your Instagram handle?
Oh, I take a
photo. What's hers?
What about Green Island? Do you guys know any like underwater stars or?
There is something really, really cool. There is a coral that is 1,200 years old.
Wow.
This is crazy, it's like super huge. Once you approach the coral, you're like, it's like just blocking the light because it's that big. Yeah. Once you get closer, you can see a lot of fish swimming around, like different microorganisms. And it just looks like a totally different world. It's like really blows your mind. And you look up, you can see a lot of fish too.
Have you guys heard of the pygmy seahorse?
Pygmy
seahorse.
Yeah.
That's an underwater superstar as well, and it's this tiny.
Really?
What?
Yeah,
this is
there.
The pygmy seahorse. It's tiny.
How did that get discovered?
10 years ago, divers in Taiwan, they fly out to, I think, Philippines or Indonesia just to see this, the right. underwater superstar.
And it turns out we have
this
them
here. Tiny. Yes. And it turns out Ludo has it. And they have different breeds of pygmy
okay.
seahorses. Okay,
wow, different species. In...
Have you guys seen it before?
Yes.
No, not yet.
No.
You have?
Yes. The first time when I saw that is my coach asked me, so look at this. I said, what?
Like,
there's
what,
nothing.
What?
Yes. What? There's nothing. And this is like super tiny, it's like this. I thought, okay, if you don't ask me to look at, I will miss it out.
Right,
so it's
right.
super cute.
It's so cute.
Yeah.
Oh
but it's really difficult to take a photo with because it's really tiny.
But I heard there is an underwater post box. Have you guys yeah. been?
Yes.
To send postcards for yourself? I have.
Really?
it's around 5 or 10 meters
do you
only.
Like put
underwater.
It in a Ziploc bag or?
Well, you can write your postcard, and it's like waterproof. It's plastic.
Okay.
And you just write it with a marker.
I bring
send
my
it to yourself.
Postcard here.
Oh,
so
yes.
I can, yeah.
Oh,
you can
feel it?
The.
You can lick it.
I can lick it.
Yeah, you can lick it. It's
and that
waterproof.
Is my address.
Yeah.
Tastes like ocean. Okay, so I see what you mean. You wrote with permanent ink.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Okay.
And you send it to yourself. I think it's really meaningful. There it is.
Yeah.
Oh, that's yeah. cute.
And that's the pygmy seahorse. 200 times bigger.
If you cannot see a seahorse, just dive to the post office.
Yeah. I got a really special experience as I followed the post officer to go down to
oh, really?
Collect for the postcard with them.
Oh.
Yeah, that's cool because this is the summertime when they open the mailbox. It's like,
yes.
wow, a lot of it. It's crazy.
Wow.
They said they will collect like 2 or 3 times per week.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah, and they will collect it all and after that, they will bring it on land and dry it off it, and after to send it to your home.
Oh, if you're not careful, this will just start scattering everywhere. That's a
yeah.
that's a tricky job.
Yes.
It's interesting, actually.
Better
Thank
not.
You.
Thank you.
Scuba divers, is there a must-go diving spot in Green Island? Pedro?
Many, many, many.
Many, many.
Really?
That's the reason why Green Island is like my top one.
Yes.
Because it's the only one where you can do the three things I love the most.
Yes.
Like,
mm-hmm.
the other islands, they all have beautiful sea and peace, but this one has cliff gaming, like cliff jumping,
Ooh.
Rock climbing,
okay.
plus nudism. The three of
them. The nudism. So you're doing all three while naked?
I'm a nudist. I've been always naked.
Okay, okay. Well, thank you for bending your rules for us.
I know, I know.
We have pictures now.
Okay.
Let's see.
All right, pictures, please.
Oh, my God.
This is cliff gaming, wow. cliff jumping, like 20 meters. And it goes together with
I'm
the other
exciting.
One, with the rock climbing, because you get up there
right.
climbing
you
without
climb
rope.
And like, then jump down.
My stomach was tingling watching him jump
yeah,
off
yeah.
the cliff.
Because
oh,
that place is a secret spot. It's Mi Jin, like not everyone knows how to get there.
So, okay. where,
not
is
easy
it?
To get
so
there.
Where is it?
It's called Xianren Tie Shi.
I got you. You said it was
still
Mi Jin.
Not easy to get
you gotta climb to it.
Oh,
it's not
okay.
easy.
You better climb.
You have to go with me if you want to find it.
All right.
Clothing optional.
not recommended.
Okay, okay.
So, any other extraordinary creatures you see while diving?
Snakes.
Snakes.
Sea
snakes?
That's scary. Yes,
I've heard
sea
they're
snakes.
Very venomous. Mm.
They are very poisonous, yeah.
They're poisonous, but they're so chill,
right.
like island people
care
as well.
About you.
Really?
They don't care about you.
All right.
They're
Even
like,
if you
go
follow
away.
Them and like take pictures of them, they're still like, I saw many like La Mei, very like hot girls with G-string taking pictures of the snake. I was looking at the girls, they were looking at the snake. And the snake.
The circle of life. The circle of life.
Yeah, everyone happy. Yeah.
Wow. We will follow Wang Ye and horses. We'll go walk around about the Xiao Liu Qiu, whole of the island.
Oh, wow.
A lot of boats and fireworks and quite impressive. Mm-hmm.
They had like techno music on it. The lights and everything was like
EDM. Yes. Take a relaxed but also a deep travel to Xiao Liu Qiu.
Xiao Liu
Qiu?
Yeah. What do you guys recommend?
Oh! Yeah. Hi!
Wow.
You again? Thank you very
Thank
much.
Thank you so much.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Oh, okay. There it is. I see something.
Yeah. It's a different horse.
It's a different horse.
Not a seahorse.
Not a seahorse, but an actual horse. And it says...
So you have horses on Xiao Liu Qiu?
Yeah, so actually that's what I want to share with the host, with the Wang Ye. So this is a traditional ceremony, and 小琉球
英王祭
that is the worshiping ceremony.
Yes.
And actually, this is the horse of the 王爷, so they select very carefully. Ooh. And during that moment, all of the attendants, we will follow 王爷 and horses will go walk around about the 小琉球, whole of the islands.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so
how long does it take to...?
For 1 week, for 7 days.
It takes 7 days to walk around the island?
Yes, actually that ceremony is for 7 days, but we take 4 days to walk around about the 小琉球. Right.
So there's 59 temples on 小琉球, which is the highest density of temples in the world.
That's one thing I noticed when I was there.
So each district, they'll spend 1 day and the whole procession will visit every temple, do a little ritual, and then leave. And so...I think there's 4 or 5 districts in 小琉球, and so each day is dedicated to one district.
Wow.
Yeah.
7 days to go through, but usually by scooter, 20 minutes.
Right.
Yeah. But we go with 4 days, actually.
Okay.
Yeah, and actually, that has only happened every 3 years.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, so last time, as for the last year, 2021.
Yes. So it's a massive event for the island, right?
Yeah.
You get to see a lot of cool stuff, like,The first day, they go with dozens of boats all around the island.
Oh, wow.
Like with fireworks.
They follow, right?
Yeah, they do circles around the island, I think. Yeah. But a lot of boats and fireworks and quite impressive. And then from the perspective of like Westerners, I'm Spanish and we have a lot of religious festivities. Like we also carry the Virgin maybe or Jesus Christ.
Right.
But they are not so cool. It's much cooler here. Much cooler. And then the music, like in Europe, is solemn and very serious and, like very ceremonial. But here it was like a party, like ba jia jiu, like
rock music. Nice.
No, we had one rattan chair that had like techno music on it.
Like, right.
The lights and everything was like
EDM. Yes.
Real respect.
Wow.
For
I love tempo.
Pretty unforgettable, right? Yeah.
Like clubbing and religion together and
all
in Taiwan.
Oh wow.
That's amazing. That is uniquely Taiwanese. Yes. I have to say.
I want to add something about like you said, the boat will circle around.小琉球 that's in Taiwanese is 孙岗卡 孙岗卡 and that is only in 小琉球 in 东港 or 南州 you won't see that because that is also pray for the people they station in the 小琉球 and they said that is not only protect the people on land and also on the ocean so that's why they have this kind of the ceremony
yeah I've heard that in 小琉球 a lot of people used to be fishermen soBeing a fisherman is a very hard job, and a lot of people lose their lives. So that's why people take it so seriously, because a lot of family members, maybe grandfathers, they went missing in the sea while fishing. So that's why they take it very, kind of close to their heart.
Wow, look at this!
Wow! Do they set that off in a pyre like that?
You can still see the ashes from that beach.
Really?
Oh my god!
That's a spectacle!
They burn the whole thing down, at the last day.
In a pile?
Yeah.
That's a two-story pile.
And also the boat. Like, the boat is...
You could probably see that from Donggang.
This is for the last day, because they believe the 王爷 came to 小琉球 will pray for the peace, and also will take away about the evil spirits.And so they burn it out and send it away from our world. So that is the picture that you can see.
Oh, including the boat. The boat is part of the pyre.
Yeah.
Wow.
Hey, this scene is quite
scary. Quite, it looks like the ocean is on fire.
No, but it's also quite moving.
Yeah.
It's
very dramatic.
Dramatic, yes.
Yeah.
But it was like, so I was deciding, I'm trying to figure it out because I know it's a religiously based festival, right? And...trying to figure out the whole thing, but it was a very festive environment. And it seemed like, and I know if you're from 小琉球and if you're like Taipei or another country, you would come back for this. And some people obviously take it very seriously, religiously, and some people, it seems like it's like a Christmas, right? Yes. It's a reason to get home and pee together with family. And so,
well, like some Scandinavians, like, set fire to giant Santa Clauses or other Christmas creations. We have this one in the, in the ocean. Yeah, we create a sea of fire. We're like literally a sea of fire. My gosh.
Wow. Dramatic. Yes.
Oh,
dramatic.
Wow.
Who's been there before?
Me by accident.
Pedro?
By accident.
I
went
to enjoy
the
water. Yeah, maybe. I would say it has good things and bad things. Because I went to enjoy the water, but it's forbidden during the festival. Like, it's 7 days where you cannot swim.
The rules.
The only 7 days out of 3 years.
And the sea turtles are like, there. Yay! No human!
No turtles for you.
Yeah. I heard there's an interesting story that Wang Ye becomes the judge.
Yes.
Oh, Jenny, yes?
Yeah, that's the impressive part of me because actually the Wang Ye interprets will inside of the human's body and become a judge. Ooh. So a lot of people will ask some of the problem of themselves and they will deal with this case.
They get a verdict from him directly.
Yes. And in Shaoliuqiu, I have a very special thing is in other places for the ceremony, Wang Ye will talk in the language of the gods. So we don't understand, I'm human.
Kind of like tongues, speaking in tongues.
Yeah, but in Shaoliuqiu, they speak in Taiwanese.
Oh, wow. Right.
So you can directly to communicate with Wang Ye by yourself. You don't need a translator.
Okay.
You can directly talk with them. Interesting, actually, because you cannot see in other place, either in Shaoliuqiu.
Yeah, Ray, if you have a chance to ask Wang Ye questions, what would you ask?
I would need a translator, though.
Speaks Taiwanese, right?
Yeah.
Question, not really into that.
Oh, yeah, but there to enjoy the festival kind of feeling.
Yeah, I like things a little mysterious.
Yeah.
I don't need to know all the answers.
I like that. I like that
perspective. You should ask which is better, Shaoliuqiu or Green Island.
Yeah,
the answer's easy.
Cosmina, what about you?
Probably if I can stay in Taiwan, if I can move to Shaoliuqiu.
You want to move to Shaoliuqiu?
Yeah.
Then you should sit over here.
I can help you.
Yeah. Thank you.
We switch.
Right, you like Ludo more, right?
No, but to live in Shaoliuqiu, if you have business in Taipei, you can live in Shaoliuqiu, and then you can just come up like I did this morning, and then be back in Shaoliuqiu the next day.
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm going back tomorrow morning.
Okay.
Well, a business trip.
Yeah.
No, this is a business trip.
Yeah, business trip. To Taipei and then back home.
And then back home tomorrow morning.
Wow!
I see all this red and yellow and orange, which is really windy, around Shaoliuqiu. And it starts to get green and blue right around Shaoliuqiu.
Where would you recommend a must go? Either Shaoliuqiu or Green Island?
There you can also go for hiking. There's like a kind of a little hill.
Okay. So it's a bit more variation.
Yeah, you can do something different rather than just like spending all your time in the water.
I'm on the island and I want to travel around. The best way to, you know, go everywhere is
scooter.
Yeah, scooter, right?
Yeah.
They have these electronic scooters.
And there's also rental.
Rentable. So, protecting the environment is a very important point as well. So you guys all love the sea. Please give just like one way to love the sea.
A way to protect the sea. Reduce consumption, no?
Reduce consumption.
Yeah,
if you don't consume, I don't even wear clothes.
No sun tanning lotion?
Yeah, nothing. No, when I go to the island, I wear like a, I just go with a plastic bag.
Okay.
Just
so cute. The
goggles,
the
goggles,
white,
that's all I need.
White and red ones.
Yeah, the blue, the white and red.
Yeah, the anything I find, I reutilize.
Go simple.
Yeah.
I find a bag, goggles in, good to go.
You don't even bring clothes.
Yeah. No, he also has some extra room. Like if you find something, you can like throw it in there.
Take it
out. Some rubbish, clean the beach.
Yes.
Yeah. Love
lovely.
The environment.
That's
love
a good
yourself.
Habit. That's a really good habit.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, instructor, what would you say?
Well, for me, the way I'm doing it is introducing people to freediving. I think it's Jacques Cousteau, who's the pioneer in scuba diving. He said, people protect what they love, and I make love to the ocean.
Wow, that's sensual.
If you go in the ocean and you're seeing trash there, you're enjoying the beauty, the absolute beauty of the ocean, and you see trash, isn't that gonna change the way when you go back to Taipei or the city that you're gonna, you know, bring your own water bottle, not, you know, get plastic all the time.
Yeah.
Rent them.
Yes.
Right. Yeah. Right. I love that system. I wish we could do that in like in the city.
Oh, slowly.
Really?
Slowly.
Is
yes.
it happening? Oh, I love yes, that happening. System. I mean, I think it's wonderful.
Yeah. Bring your own bottle, bring your own lunch boxes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, reduce plastic, mm-hmm. like one-time use plastic. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. To reduce to use the sun cream.
Yeah. Yes.
And I think in the Green Island and in Xiaoliuqiu, they have a plan that you bring your garbage by yourself.
Yes.
You take back to the island in Taiwan.
Right.
So I think that would be the better for to save the environment yeah. in both of the islands.
Yeah. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. And I think to protect something, first you need to start with yourself,
yeah.
but then also remind other people. So if you see someone is throwing the trash on the beach,
beat them up.
Right. Yeah, yeah. Beat them up.
Yeah. Take
make
a
sure they're bleeding and yeah. then tell them to pick that trash.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
You watch yeah. out. Next time you do that, you know.
All right.
Be careful.
Oh man.
The first time I've been there, we did like a night tour.
Yeah.
So like I think it was the owner of the Minsu where we're staying at, I forgot. He organized a tour for us and went down to the ocean and showed us like the sea creatures that you only can see during the night. Mm. And he also reminded everyone, he was like, did you apply sunscreen before? Oh. If yes, please don't put your hand into
right.
the ocean.
Okay.
If you didn't apply any sunscreen, you're good
you're
to
welcome.
Go. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes, so that's very important.
Right.
If I wanted to plan a trip to Xiaoliuqiu, how can I plan it? What's the best way to plan my vacation?
Well, depends what kind of person are you. You just mm-hmm. want to, sometimes you don't
your
need to plan.
Your suggestion.
Because I think you just can't overplan and just go to Xiaoliuqiu to chill.
Just do nothing.
Island vibes.
Leave your brain in the city.
Just see where it leads you.
Right.
Right?
Go
not,
with the
not
flow.
Not everything needs to be planned.
Okay.
But I would suggest first take a free dive course with me.
Okay. That could be part of the plan.
Productive, being productive yeah. while on a vacation. That's good.
Yeah.
Because if you go to the island and you don't jump in the sea, it's such a pity.
It's a bit yeah. of a waste, yeah. I'd feel.
But one benefit of Xiaoliuqiu is that it's all year round. You can dive,
right.
scuba dive, everything, all year round.
Okay.
And the typhoon doesn't go there either.
Rarely, very rarely.
Very rare.
Yeah.
Very rarely.
Yes.
But when there is a typhoon anywhere in the area,
that's
the ferry's
true.
Shut.
I mean,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
we are an island too, so like whenever it hits one part of the island, the other part kind of feels it too, you know? Mm-hmm. Like,
but not as bad,
yeah,
because
exactly.
Xiaoliuqiu is kind of protected.
Yeah.
Oh, you have the reefs underneath.
I see the like the way the winds are and its location relative to the main island,
mm-hmm.
the winds just go around it.
That's amazing.
Yes. I mean, I obviously look at the winds every day because it affects, you know, where I free dive on the island. And sometimes you'll see like red is like super windy. I see all this red and yellow and orange, which is really windy around Xiaoliuqiu, and it starts to get green and blue right around Xiaoliuqiu.
Oh.
So yeah.
Lucky island.
Yes, very.
Yeah.
So one for Xiaoliuqiu.
Yes, yes, yes. We will vote later. Cosima, what about you? Where would you recommend a must go? Either Xiaoliuqiu or Green Island?
I think Xiaoliuqiu.
Really?
Yes.
Please
yeah.
sit here.
Like, yeah. Yes, let's change. I just think it's more convenient to go there.
Mm-hmm, right. Mm-hmm. Lena?
I think it also depends on your budget. Mm. If you're more tight in your budget, then Xiaoliuqiu, of course, because the food is cheaper, accommodation cheaper, ferry cheaper. To get there is also easier and faster. But if you want more of totally like rewiring yourself, I think maybe Green Island is better because first of all, it takes you more time to get there, so we'd probably prefer spending there more time.
Yes.
And plus, the island is bigger than Xiaoliuqiu, so there you can also go for hiking. There's like a kind of a little hill.
Okay. So it's a bit more variation.
Yeah, you can do something different rather than just like spending all your time in the water.
Yes. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. Both of them are really beautiful, very nice. So yeah, if you have more time, Green Island. If you have less time, Xiaoliuqiu.
Okay, wow, okay. Oh, I like that. I like yeah. that you broke that down.
She's a nice person.
Yeah.
She likes both.
Yeah, yeah, very diplomatic.
Yes.
Not like Jenny.
Not like Jenny.
Okay,
your turn, yes.
Yeah. Actually, I like both, but Ludao is better for me, actually.
Uh-oh.
But I recommend you, if you plan to go to Xiaoliuqiu or Ludao, maybe you can stay for at least 3 days,
right?
Or 4 days. I think that would be a better trip.
Right.
Because actually in there, you must feel like chill
yes.
mm-hmm. and just enjoy the time. And I super recommend that you can start to go to the ocean and doing the diving in the Xiaoliuqiu or in the Ludao because that is full HD inside
right.
of the water.
Right, right, right. So guys, if you're watching and you're coming to Taiwan, please plan your trip longer because mm-hmm. apart from our main island, our other islands.
Yeah, our offshore islands.
Offshore islands are perfect and a must go, okay? Yeah. No matter if you're choosing between Green Island, 小琉球, 蓝屿, 澎湖, whatever. Please enjoy Taiwan, and we'll see you in the sea, yeah?
See you soon.
Wow, Taiwan, see you next time.
Bye.
Bye, thanks, guys. Bye. 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 Bye.